Good morning, everyone. Welcome back to another CeCe's Fashion is My Passion YouTube video. You hear that little sound? That somebody texting me, so I apologize for that. But you know, I always come on once a week in the middle of the week, and I do a Let's Chat segment. So today, I want to do a little talk about something that I've been thinking about recently. So today's Let's Chat message is about gifts. Gifts. Now, for anyone that's looking at this video, if you like to receive a gift, raise your hand. I don't know one person on the planet that does not like to receive a gift, whether it's a birthday gift, whether it's a Christmas gift, or if it's a just because I was thinking of you gift. Everybody loves to get a gift. I don't care what's inside the box. I don't care what's inside the bag. You may not know what's in there, and you may not like it once you unwrap it. But when somebody gives you something, and something from the heart, it surprises you. It throws you off. It makes you go, oh, you thought of me. Thank you. You know how we do. So, these gifts that I'm talking about today are not the material gift, not the silver earrings, not the rings or necklace or anything of that nature. But the gifts that I'm talking about are the gifts that God has given you free of charge. Gifts that you didn't ask for, gifts that you didn't even know that you had, and gifts that you didn't even think that maybe you deserve, but yet and still, he gave them to you. And in the midst of him giving you your gifts are your talents. And a lot of us don't even know the many gifts that God has already given us. We don't realize it, we don't recognize it, and we don't even know that it's there until we start to do something or embark on a new journey, and then we say, hey, I didn't know that I was good at doing this or that or the other. I didn't know that I had this gift, but you do. But the message that I want to send to all of you is that although you may not know right now what your gifts are, or what your talents are, stop running and chasing after other folks' gifts. Every gift ain't meant for everybody. Come on, somebody. Every gift, let me say that one more time. Every gift ain't meant for everybody. Okay? And here's the other thing. Oftentimes, you will get a gift, and it may not come the way you think that it should. Let me give you a little story. At the age of 18, my gynecologist told me that I would never, ever be able to conceive nor give birth to a child. At the age of 38, I had my first child. He is now 13. I never, ever thought that I would have a child. I never, ever thought I would be a mother. In fact, I was fine with not having children because I am not a kid type of person. So, although I was told that, there was still a part of me deep down somewhere inside of me that I think that I did want to have a baby, but I just wasn't sure about when, who, with, how, this, that, or the third. What I always wanted was to be married and then have a child. I wanted that family life because that's how I grew up. I grew up with a mother and a father. I grew up in a two-parent home, and that's what I desired for myself as well. However, it didn't come that way. Sometimes we look for the gift with the big red shiny bow or the little frilly things hanging off of the package or how well wrapped the package is. But that's not always how it comes. And so when we get a gift, we got to know how to receive that gift And not always looking at what the other person over there, oh, what you get? Oh, what you got? Oh, how is your gift wrapped? Your gift is not going to be wrapped like CeCe's gift. And CeCe's gift not going to be wrapped like I Am Jay or Jill Styles or So Me or Ty's Kitchen. I could go on and name all of these wonderful YouTube contenters that are on YouTube that I follow. Everybody's gift is not the same. What CeCe can do, maybe somebody else can't do. What I Am Jay, Miss Jill Styles, Renee, Miss Renee, and just throwing out some names, what they can do, I can't do. But here's what I do know, is that I realize and I recognize that my gift belongs to me, and their gift belongs to them. And I'm not looking, and I'm not chasing Vanessa Crusoe, the plus size queen, or Nick Technics. I'm not chasing their dreams. I'm not chasing their gifts. But I can be supportive and support them in the gifts that they have and the talent that they have. And say, sis, you look beautiful. Sis, you rocking it. Because I know what my gifts are. My gifts are not their gifts. And we all do things differently. So I just use these people just as some few examples. But let me get back to my main story. At the age of 38, I had my first child. It did not come the way in which I had planned for it to come. It didn't come the way I had visualized it in my mind for it to happen. I had a child. I had a child out of wedlock, my first child. I was very devastated. I was very upset. The relationship between, I cannot respectfully call him his father because he is not a acting participant in his life. So I will just say the other party to be nice. Because that ain't what I really want to say. Okay. So it didn't go the way in which I wanted it to go. The relationship ended. I ended it. I was alone, pregnant, didn't know what to do, upset, felt like I had disappointed my family, especially my father. You all know I've talked about my father passing. But what I didn't realize in the midst of what I had did, not the correct way or the way that I was raised to do it, was that my son was still a gift. It took me until he was about 2 years old to realize that this was a gift that God had given me that I did not ask for, that I did not want or necessarily wasn't even able to receive it because I was too immature. I didn't get it. I didn't get it until I saw how much joy that one gift that God gave me that I thought that I would never get brought so many people joy. See, your gift is your gift, but when you share the gift that God has blessed you with other people and make other people happy and smile. See, when we, all of these YouTube contenters, when we get on YouTube and we do our thing, we don't know who we inspiring. We don't know who was on the edge that day of committing suicide. But maybe they turned on a YouTube channel and they heard Miss Renee read a word from the mantra book. We don't know if somebody looked at the plus size queen or Nick Technics and said, you know what? I think I can do that. I was feeling self-conscious about my body. I'm looking at these two women, these two sisters who get on and they rock their swimsuits and they thongs and they lingerie. Or they look at Jill Style and they say, you know what? I really believe I have a creative side after looking at her do home decor. We don't know. We don't know how we are helping somebody else not go over the edge by what we're doing. on this platform. We don't know if a young woman is looking at IMJ or the plus size queen and saying, you know what? I need to do better. These are some young women that are classy, that get on YouTube and have hit over 1,000 YouTube subscribers, and their channel is building and building. So you don't know what young woman is looking at you all and saying, not that I want to be like IMJ, or not that I want to be like the plus size queen, but some type of way you're inspiring them in some shape, form, or fashion. So when I had my son, I was devastated. I was broken. I had help from my family. But what I'm saying to you all is that the thing that I longed for did not happen. And that was to have a man there with me as I was going through this process of pregnancy. I was alone for 9 months in my apartment by myself. I went through bringing him into the world. I had a C-section. My sister was there. But what I longed for was not there. And it devastated me to the point that after I had my son, it was hard for me to even be in mommy mode, because it was hard for me to enjoy him, because I was still dealing with that BS from the other participant. And it wasn't until I let that go and stopped focusing on that and started really realizing what God had did. That God had given me something that somebody said I would never have, that I would never experience. So when I realized that my gift didn't come with the big red shiny bow, and it didn't come with the frilly dangles on the end of the paper, and it didn't come with the real glossy wrapping paper, but yet it was still a gift. It was a gift. It was a gift. And what God spoke to me and said one day to me, stop focusing on that and get back over here to this. I gave you this. I did this. Not you, not him, me. Because if you recall, they said it wasn't possible. But with me, all things are possible. When you put your trust and when you believe in me. So what I want to say to each and every last one of you all looking at this video, don't give up on your gifts. And be able to recognize when you got a good gift. No matter what it comes packaged in, no matter how the presentation comes, it's still a gift from the Most High. Amen? Can somebody say amen? I don't know what your religious affiliations are, but what I will say is that each and every last one of you deserve to have what you want and the way in which you want it. But you got to lean on him, and you got to believe in him and believe that it's possible. So if you are someone today that hasn't really recognized what your gift is or what your talent is, sit back, think on it, think about who you are, and think about where you want to go and what you want to do. And then get up and go do it. Stop procrastinating. Stop looking over here at your girlfriend over there, over here. Stop talking about, well, they got this and I ain't got that. What they got ain't meant for you. What God has for you is for you. I say it all the time. You all have heard me say it on my YouTube video. What God has for you is for you. And can't nobody, no, even at my neighbor, can't nobody take away what God has for you. Because see, God already knew what he was going to do with you before you decided to do what you was going to do. We deviate from it because we don't know. And we try to do it our way. But God already know how he going to do what he going to do. So don't go chasing. Don't go looking. Don't go trying to be like anybody else. Just be you and watch God work. Watch him work. But know this, that whatever way that your gifts may come, realize that it's a good gift. Don't be looking over in somebody else's backyard to see what they got. Don't be trying to be what somebody else is. Because see, that's when jealousy and envy and hate comes upon us. But say, God, I thank you. I thank you for what you've given me. And I thank you for things that I don't even know that is here in me that you are going to show up and show out and rediscover that thing that I don't know is here. And start thanking God for it. But you can't get what is for you if you're trying to get something else that ain't for you. You can't get what's for you if you're trying to get something else that ain't for you. Stop running after somebody's husband. Stop running after somebody's wife. Stop trying to drive the same car that your neighbor got or your sister got or your brother got. Wait on God. Wait on God. He coming. He coming. He may not come when you want him to, but he coming. But he cannot show up and show out if you got jealousy, if you don't know how to support somebody else, if you don't know how to say you beautiful, you wonderful, congratulations, I'm happy for you, sis, deep down from your soul and mean it. And mean it. See, when you love you and you know who you are, you ain't got time to be looking over there seeing what somebody else got. Because you know who you are. And you know whose you are. Don't be confused. Don't get caught up. Because the devil is busy. And he gets in our head and tell us, you ain't going nowhere on YouTube. You ain't going to hit 1,000 subscribers. Who looking at that mess? Ain't nobody looking at you, girl. Ain't nobody looking at your channel. Don't let the devil tell you nothing that you know is not the truth about yourself. So I hope every last one of you all that are looking at this, recognize what the gift is that God has given you. And it may not be the biggest talent in the world, but we all have been blessed with a gift. If you don't know what it is, then I would say to you to go somewhere, sit, get quiet, close your eyes, and meditate on him. And God will give you what you need to know about you. I hope you guys really listen to this message and know that you are great. And it is he that is greater in you than he that is in the world. The greatness is here. I may have said that scripture wrong, but you Bible people know what I'm saying. Greater is he that is in me than is in the world. I think I said it right. I think I did. But the greatness is in you because you were created by God. And I'm not on here to preach to you all about God. I'm not on here really even to preach about anything. I just wanted to give that message to somebody who's feeling discouraged. And to somebody who's feeling like, when? When is it going to happen for me? When? Because I'm one of those people. When? Lord, when? When? When, Jesus? But what I do know is that God has never failed me. He has never forsaken me. He has never led me or steered me wrong. So if it does not come, it was not meant for me to have it. See, I'm now in a point in my life that I'm asking God to lead me and guide me in each and every direction of my life. Because I'm no longer young. I'm in that middle age thing, right? So I don't have a whole lot of time like I did when I was 20. So I'm asking, I'm more centered and I'm more focused. And I said, God, you do a new thing. I'm not going to do it. I'm going to wait on you, Jesus. to do a new thing. And your new thing may be something that you ain't even expecting. But be encouraged. Be encouraged. Don't be discouraged, but be encouraged. And know that the gift may not come wrapped with a pretty red bow. But nevertheless, the gift is there and the gift is coming. But you'll be in a place to receive it, whatever it may be and whatever way it may come. Receive it, embrace it, and after you receive it, unwrap it, embrace it, and know that it's for you, lift your hands and say, thank you, Jesus, hallelujah. I give you honor, glory, and praise, oh God, because you're good to me just like that. Amen, somebody. Come on, somebody. Amen, 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 amen. I think I spoke a word today. So have a blessed and safe and wonderful Thanksgiving. If you celebrate Thanksgiving, eat as much as you want. Laugh as much as you want. Give God some praise and some thanks because you're here. Be encouraged. Be inspired. That's my word for today on this Let's Chat. God bless you all. And thank you all so much for subscribing. Sister girl. Sister girl. Me, who was about to give up on YouTube. Let me tell y'all. I hit 800 subscribers today, baby. What? What? Oh, yes, I did. Yes, I did. Yes, I did that thing. I did that thing. So thank you all again for supporting me. I love you all. Oh, and I forgot to mention another YouTube subscriber who I love. Candy Ma. Candy Ma. Candy Ma. Candy Ma. She's another one that got an amazing talent, an amazing gift. Okay, so you all the ladies that I mentioned, I'm going to do another video giving some more shout outs to subscribe to people. Miss Baddie on a Budget is another young lady that is new to YouTube that I want to really help and support. And I also, before I end this video, I want to give my sincere condolences to Shaquita Lynn, Hippie Chick. She lost her mom recently. She is one of my subscribers, and I am subscribed to her channel as well. She does fashion as well. She's back. She had been gone for a couple of months. She lost her mom, and she is really struggling. Every last person looking at this, if you lost someone near and dear to you, whether it be a parent, whether it was a loved one or a friend, we all have been through it, and some of us is going through it. Special prayers out to Jill Stiles, who lost her great nephew. Baby was only a couple of months old. I want to send a special prayer out to Jill Stiles. As you all know, Jill lost her sister and her nephew recently, and now another death in the family of a baby. So those two ladies, Jill Stiles and Shaquita Lynn Hippie Chick, keep them in your prayers, especially this holiday season as we're going forth into Thanksgiving and then Christmas. This is a hard and trying time for a lot of people. So keep them in your prayers and pray for them. And just, you know, want to send my sincerest condolences out to these two ladies who recently, you know, lost someone. But again, in the midst of that, in the midst of it all, God is still good. So I want to let you all know that I'm praying for you. I ask that you continue to pray for me. And I hope that you all have a wonderful Thanksgiving. That you just enjoy your time with your family and your friends. So God bless you. I love you. And I'll see you where? Say it with me. In the next CC's Fashion is My Passion YouTube video. Bye. God bless you.